Question number two, Alastair Scott.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. My question is to the Minister of Finance and asks, what reports has he received that expect the economy to deliver more jobs and higher wages for New Zealand families over the next 3 years?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Mr. Speaker, I've seen a recent report from NZIER, which makes some good comments about the New Zealand economy if I could just find my answers, Mr. Speaker. Good comments about the New Zealand economy and says it will continue to grow, continue to add jobs and continue to lift New Zealanders' incomes in the years ahead.
Thank you for the answer. I have a supplementary question.
Supplementary question, Alastair Scott.
What is the NZIER's assessment of the outlook for various sectors?
Order. I hope it is a sensible point of order.
Important point of order, Mr. Speaker. I just wanted to give the Minister a little time to find his laminated pads.
Order. And that is not a point of order. That's the sort of point of order that actually creates more disorder. Supplementary question, Alastair Scott.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. To the Minister, what is the NZIER's assessment of the outlook for various sectors in the economy?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Mr. Speaker, on behalf of the Minister of Finance, while NZIER notes the fall in dairy prices has had a significant effect, a range of industries continue to support growth. Construction activity remains strong, supported by much higher levels of house building activity in Auckland and increased non-residential construction. Wool, kiwifruit, pipfruit and meat are all undergoing a revival. Kiwifruit export volumes are soaring. Business investment and hiring intentions remain solid. NZIER reports tourism and manufacturing are benefiting from a lower New Zealand dollar and higher global demand. And the lower New Zealand dollar and the high US beef prices are providing some relief to dairy farmers who are culling unproductive stock.
Supplementary question, Alastair Scott.
What reports has he received showing increasing exports are supporting growth and resilience in the New Zealand economy?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Well, Mr. Speaker, this is very interesting for the House on behalf of the Minister of Finance. Statistics New Zealand yesterday released its report on overseas merchandise trade for July. The value of goods exports in July of this year was 4.2 billion New Zealand dollars, or just over half a billion, or 14% higher than the same month a year earlier. Meat exports were up 24%, led by beef, and that was up 40% alone due to higher prices. Fruit exports increased by 32% to $311 million. And the value of dairy exports was up slightly by nearly $1 million to $932 million, with increases in cheese, dairy spreads and milk protein offsetting the fall in milk powder exports.
Supplementary.
Supplementary question, Julie Ann Genta.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Can he confirm that 52,000 more people are unemployed now than when he took office? That's 54%. And why does he think that the policies he's been implementing over the last 7 years will give a different outcome over the next three?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce, those two supplementary questions.
Well, Mr. Speaker, on behalf of the Minister of Finance, the member may or may not be aware that actually the number of people employed is significantly higher than it was 7 years ago either, because the labour market has expanded substantially over that period. And of course, again, the member may not be aware, but we had the global financial crisis and the Canterbury earthquakes, which caused significant dislocations to our employment market over that period. The government is confident that New Zealand is continuing to deliver very high levels of employment, I think from memory about the fifth highest in the OECD, and that is continuing to improve over time through the careful stewardship of the economy, which encourages investment and growth.
Supplementary question, Alastair Scott.
To the Minister, what steps is the government taking to support the New Zealand economy in uncertain times?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Mr. Speaker, on behalf of the Minister of Finance, the government is continuing to undertake a range of measures as part of its plan to support a resilient, growing economy. The government's fiscal constraint is taking pressure off exchange and interest rates, which supports less borrowing and higher national savings. We remain on track to surplus and to begin paying down debt. We're reducing costs through ACC levy reductions. We've lowered taxes for work and savings. We're boosting business R&D funding. And we're on track to deliver $110 billion of investment in infrastructure over the next 10 years. And the government's business growth agenda is helping businesses to have the confidence to invest and supporting regions to take advantage of economic opportunities.
Supplementary?
Supplementary question, Julianne Genta.
Has he seen any reports such as that from President Obama that job growth in the American solar industry is 10 times higher than other industries? And what specific actions is his government taking to remove the barriers to growth in low-carbon industries?
Again, the Honourable Stephen Joyce, either of those two supplementary
questions. Well, Mr Speaker, on behalf of the Minister of Finance, the government is spending a considerable effort making sure there is no regulatory impacts to the development, restrictions on the development of new industries. But where I probably would differ from the member is we also won't be planning big new subsidies to new industries either, because that would actually be a drag on the New Zealand economy rather than encouraging the growth of the New Zealand economy, Mr Speaker. And this government is focused on growing the New Zealand economy. The good news for the member, of course, is that renewable energy is probably higher in New Zealand than most of the developed world.
Supplementary question.
Order. I'm just waiting for the colleagues. Supplementary question, Julianne Genta.
How can he claim that his government doesn't want to pick winners when ministers in this House are constantly standing up talking about the support they're giving to the dairy industry, the wine industry, the fossil fuel exploration industry, and why wouldn't he support renewable growth, as that's not only going to grow jobs but help us thrive in the low-carbon future?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce, either of those two supplementary questions.
Well, Mr Speaker, on behalf of the Minister of Finance, that where the government does make a contribution, and the member has identified some areas, particularly is in the areas of research and development, through such things as the Primary Growth Partnership, through the Callaghan Innovation R&D Growth Grant Schemes and so on. And the member may be interested to know that an industry such as ICT and high-tech manufacturing has seen very considerable growth in R&D and in activity generally, in terms of the development of diversification of New Zealand industries. But I think that's fine, and in fact that's available now to all of the renewable energy industries the member talks of. What we're not prepared to do is go further than that and subsidise, for example, the price or the uptake of a particular industry.
Question number three, the Honourable Annette King.
Thank you, Mr Speaker. My question